Silverton Audio presents The Unabridged Recording of Normal Secrets, a search for identity, growth, love, and motorcycles, a memoir, written by Walter F. Kern, narrated by Connor Goff. Preface. This memoir is a departure from the motorcycle themes of my previous four books. For a long time, I have been thinking how I might unveil secrets that my ancestors held tightly in the shadows. But would those secrets even be interesting to a general audience, I wondered. After all, I'm not a famous politician, business leader, rock star, or movie or television entertainer. I guess I've lived a life much like that of my readers. But it does have unusual twists and turns known only by a few family members. Many secrets revealed here were unknown to me until late in life. They had to be mined slowly from personal interviews, genealogical studies, public records, and some cutting-edge scientific laboratory work accomplished by worldwide experts. My story isn't complete yet, but I thought it was time at the age of 79 that I should attempt to put it down in a memoir. A memoir is not supposed to be an autobiography of one's entire life. Rather, it should focus on a few notable portions, including people and events that shaped the writer's life. I hope you will gain a better understanding of my life as I pursued it, not even knowing who I was, what I was searching for, who I would marry, how I would deal with adversity, and why I would come to be so intimately involved with, of all things, motorcycles. But my greater hope is that you will travel along with me on my journey and consider what you would have done at each decision point. Did I make the right choice? Did I make the wrong choice? Are you learning anything that might help you in your own journey? I sincerely hope that you will benefit from reading this memoir. I've told some of my life stories to a few people, but I'm sure not many remember the details. This memoir sets down in print what significant events I remembered, what people were important to me, how I went about solving problems, and what I gave back to others. I was fortunate in that I took the time to write about some of my experiences, and publish some, shortly after they occurred. These are also included in the memoir. Since these additional writings were done at different ages, I left them unedited to preserve both the way I was thinking at the time and how I put my words down on paper. Also, some of the people in my life sent me letters that I considered to be significant to the telling of this story. I have also used their exact words, unedited. Perhaps the pathway I traveled, using the mind to rise up and move forward to an uncertain future, will prompt readers to examine their own lives and, likewise, assist them in their own growth. Chapter 1. A Few Drops of Blood. Do nothing secretly, for time sees and hears all things, and discloses all. Sophocles. October 13, 1998. I was a bit nervous today, alone in the house, waiting to uncover a secret. I was seated in my family room on the white, well-worn imitation leather couch. I was facing the front door and had my arms on a fold-up wooden TV tray. On the tray were a small piece of white cotton cloth and a set of instructions. The instructions, below, had arrived in an email from a researcher at Oxford University in England. Step 1. Spot a few drops of blood onto a piece of clean cloth. Step 2. Allow to dry in the air at room temperature. Step 3. Place in a paper envelope or between sheets of clean, dry paper and store dry at room temperature. Step 4. When you have both samples, send them to us in the post. When I first read the instructions a week ago, I was concerned when the first step said, spot a few drops of blood onto a piece of clean cloth. I had never even liked the sight of blood. Now I had been asked to cut myself intentionally. That was not going to happen. But I had to do it, I conceded, to find out the truth. Immediately, I thought of my firstborn son, David.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books,
Use the link in the video description.